So you want to go kayaking when you're in Saint Augustine, Florida. You have to go out at night. I know you might think, gosh, why would I want to go out at night? It's so dark because of these guys, comb jellies, bioluminescence. Florida is world famous for having bioluminescent kayaking, but very few people know that it's in Saint Augustine, Florida. Just a couple of years ago, I discovered that we had comb jellies living in Iguana Lake. Iguana Lake is just north of St. Augustine. It's 2 foot deep. The comb jellies are right there when you get in, so there's not a lot of kayaking, and you start seeing bioluminescence. As soon as it gets dark, the magic comes out, and I mean, as you can see, they sparkle. This is because there's light reflecting on it, so you bring a flashlight with you to see the effects like that going up and down. But otherwise, they glow when you hit them and you see swirls of light going in the lake. This is a year-round phenomena. We see fluctuations based upon weather and depending on what the scientists are doing with the lake, because they can raise and lower. Comb jellies are all over the intracoastal and they're constantly coming into Iguana Lake. And since it's behind a dam, everything gets stuck in there. So therefore, it's not like you expect in other parts where the bioluminescence is only available in the summer. Comb jellies are available all year round. There's 150 species around the globe. They live from pole to pole, summer, winter, there's a comb jelly. And plus, bioluminescence is pretty common. There's 75% of life in the ocean is bioluminescence, and whatever comes into that dam gets stuck. So when we're out there at night, every single night we've been out there since 2020, we've seen some bioluminescence out there. Sometimes it's phenomenal, it's over the top, it's absolutely amazing. Sometimes there's just a few. So it's like going to a garden. Sometimes there's a few flowers, sometimes there's a lot of flowers. And same thing with fireflies. Another type of bioluminescence, it lives on land. Very little life on land is bioluminescence, less than 0.1% versus a 75% of bioluminescence in the oceans, right? So you have a couple of fireflies. Hey, that's cool, right? So it's a good night kayaking no matter what. You want to go out, the darker it is, the brighter the bioluminescence will appear. So if the moon is out, you may have little reflections on the water that can interfere with your ability to see it readily, but you'll catch it. You can hold it in a cup and get a close look at it, see its organelles, and you're gonna go out with your guide and you're gonna learn all sorts of interesting things about these comb jellies. They're amazing. I mean, look at these things. Would you believe that 520 million years ago, these came onto the scene? Our fossil record tells us these are the oldest known animals in our fossil record. There's nothing older than the comb jelly that was sexually reproducing. Before this, everything was cell division, asexual, right? And then all of a sudden, here comes something that begins sexually reproducing. It's very successful. It can eat a lot. It doesn't have to wait to digest. It develops the ability like we have to be able to eat from one end and pass it out the other. And it became so incredibly successful that geneticists and you know, everybody that's studying it tells us that the comb jelly is the spark that started the Cambrian age, where all animal life in the animal kingdom, which we belong to, came into existence. And a couple 350 million years later, we've got dinosaurs, you know, and now us, descendants genetically of this guy, the comb jelly, bioluminescence. It's cool. You can come out and see it while you're kayaking in St. Augustine, Florida. You've got to go out at night, because if you don't go out at night, you're not going to see the bioluminescence glowing. The bioluminescence is always there. Even if you're in Iguana Lake during the day, you can catch them and take a look at them and see them sparkling like you see in this video here. These things are phenomenally interesting. Would you believe that they are cannibals? There's one species of comb jelly that at the end of the summer, they have a mating season. They spawn. You know, most life, you think of having a mating season in the spring so that the young have a chance with good weather and to survive. But these comb jellies, at the end of the summer, they know that their food's going to be running out, so they spawn to have babies, so they have something to eat. Like, they're literally having children to eat them. Imagine that. Kids, you better behave. You're lucky your parents aren't a comb jelly. I mean, you're going to go out there, you're going to hear some amazing stories. The comb jelly has a form of green fluorescent protein that's used in science. There's so many discoveries that have been made because of the glowing of the comb jellies. They're absolutely fascinating. If a comb jelly starts starving, maybe it's one of the species that doesn't reproduce to eat their children. There's other species that they can kind of go into a fasting state and they reverse back in age and they wait until food and conditions get better. And then they start eating again and become adults. And in a laboratory setting, scientists were able to keep a comb jelly alive for 10 years by starving it and feeding it, and then starving it and feeding it. So yeah, I don't think you realize how cool these comb jellies are. Most people, first of all, don't even realize that we have bioluminescence kayaking in St. Augustine. They think it's just during the summer, but we have bioluminescence kayaking in St. Augustine all season long. Now, again, levels of bioluminescence in Iguana Lake, they go up and down when you go kayaking in the winter. The park's open till 9, so you don't even need a kayak to go out there. So go have fun, go kayaking, enjoy the bioluminescence when you're kayaking in St. Augustine, Florida at night.